Good morning, class. Now for our today's presentation, as you can all see in the screen, it's about do's and don'ts while using our computer. We have discussed this lesson in our last class, and we will have a quick recap of the whole chapter because from today we will be starting a new chapter. All right. So before that, let us revise. Let us begin. Do's and don'ts of using a computer. Now children, few things you need to keep your mind when you are using computer, whether it is in your home or whether it is you are using in the school. There is some rules which you need to maintain. Let us follow or understand those rules. Those are the things we should do when we use the computer. We should always use the computer with the permission of our teacher, of our parents. We should always keep quiet in the computer lab and listen to what our teacher is saying. We should always take help from the teacher whenever we are stuck with something, whenever we need her help. We should always sit straight in front of the computer. Posture is very important, you should remember that, alright? We should press the keys of the keyboard gently and don't press them too hard or it will damage. We should always use the mouse with a mouse pad. That is very important, you need to remember that. We should always shut down the computer after our work is over. We should put dust covers on the computer system to protect them from the pollution outside. We should always keep our computer system clean and dry. Now let us know the things we should not do. First of all, we should never switch off our computer system directly from the main switchboard or pressing the main button. Otherwise, it might disrupt the power supply. We should never touch or play with the wires of the computer. You should always remember this, children, that is very dangerous to do so. We should not touch the mouse and the keyboard with dirty hands. This makes the mouse and the keyboard keys dirty and sticky. We should not eat while we are working on the computer. We should not bring food and drinks near the computer screen. We should never break computer rules, and we should never let our friends break the rules either. Now, children, for our next slide, we are again recapitulating about the whole thing. Now imagine a little girl like you, a child like you, going to the computer and the computer is speaking for itself. It is a very fancy thing to imagine, but here I have tried to represent something like that, that if the computer was a person and the computer would have spoken for itself, what different things it would have told you? How to maintain while working on the computer, what things you must do and what things you must not do. We must take off our shoes before entering the computer room to maintain the cleanliness. We must maintain a queue to enter the computer room in order to avoid a crowded situation. Also, we must maintain silence inside the computer room so that all can concentrate on the work. The computer should be kept dust-free, neat and clean, and it should be covered properly when it's not in use, which I have mentioned in my previous slide as well. The computer should be switched off when you are not using it, so that to avoid useless consumption of electricity. We must not press the computer keys roughly, as it might damage the keyboard. We must not touch the main switch, as the electrical wires are connected to the computer, which I have also mentioned in my previous slide. And we should never eat or drink anything on the computer table, otherwise it might fall on your keyboard and can damage it. The food might get spilled on it, right? And posture is very important. When you're sitting in front of the computer, you must sit straight. Your eyes should be directly related to the computer screen. Also, when you're cleaning the computer, you should use a clean, dry cotton cloth. Okay? We should not pour water while cleaning our computer or laptops. It will be a total toss for it. And suppose when you're not using the computer, don't cover it fully, because it generates heat. And when such things happen, the computer gets spoiled very soon. Okay? It might damage soon enough. So, children, as you can see, in a fancy way, the computer has spoken for itself and made you understand what you must do and what you must not do. Alright? Now, finally, let us revise once more, because as I said, we are going to begin a new chapter today. So, a quick recap once again. We are doing few key points to remember from the chapter as a whole. As we were learning to take care of our computer, we all know it's an electronic machine, and we all know what are the do's and don'ts of the computer, right? We have discussed that. So let us revise those points once again. Be safe. Computer works on electricity. You must be gentle, because computer is very delicate. You must keep your computer clean, because dust is very harmful. It might damage the computer. And a bad posture can harm your back. So a good posture is very important. We must try and keep our computer and the surroundings very clean and tidy. Use a proper clean dry cloth. We must gently cover the computer before we leave the computer lab room. If there is any teacher present in the lab room, any elder present at your home, you must take help from them and not use the wire by yourself. You must turn off the computer monitor when you are not using it for over 20 minutes. We must maintain a proper distance from the computer screen, because otherwise it might create damage. And lastly, we must make sure to handle our computer with care. Okay? And suppose if you are thirsty while using the computer, or you are hungry while using the computer, then also you have to keep in mind, you need to get up from your table and go to your dining area to have your food. Don't bring your food near the computer and eat, because it might fall on your keyboard and it might create damage. Don't insert any finger or pencil, eraser inside in your computer CPU. You should never touch the wires of the computer, no matter what. And as I mentioned, don't sit too close near the computer. Definitely never bang on the computer keyboard. Alright? Now, there are some question answers prepared here. You can always play in your free time when you're playing using your computer. You can solve those questions that is present at the last screen page. Very few basic MCQ is present there. Alright? So, children, I hope the chapter is very clear to you. And I hope the PowerPoint presentation will be of some help. And today we are going to start a new chapter, and the video of which I will upload next week after having a quick revision. Alright, thank you.